Let's do a swordsman react to Ivanhoe 1952, the final battle. Hey folks, Matt Easton here, Schola Gladiatoria. So I normally teach HEMA, that is sort of historical combat with weapons and stuff. So I also do things with armour and I deal in antique arms and armour. Now, earlier on today, a friend of mine, Dr. Tobias Capel from the Wallace Collection, shared this awesome fight scene, which I vaguely remember from the film Ivanhoe from 1952, I have seen this a long time ago, but I don't remember it clearly. I only vaguely remember it. So I'm going to film a react video to what I make of this, and we'll see if there's anything interesting to talk about as we go along. So first thing I have to say, so this is set in, supposed to be set in about the 1190s. But do you know what there, and this is what Dr. Tobias Capel was talking about, was the fact that the overall look of this is absolutely luscious and victorious. It's amazing. It's fantastic. It really gives you the feel and the look of the medieval period, and you know, the sort of classic age of knights in most people's mindsets. And the look of this is so much more accurate to what we see in manuscripts and period art, and also the surviving artifacts as well. And talking about that, the arms and armour. Now, I have to say the equipment of this looks more like something from the 1200s, maybe the middle of the 13th century, rather than the end of the 1100s or late 12th century. But that being said, this is still far more historically accurate than pretty much anything we see in most modern movies. And there's been a few trailers released, which I'm sure some of you will have seen recently, for some upcoming movies, and certainly one of those in particular is horribly historically inaccurate. But the arms and armor in this actually look way better. Let's look at the fight.
May God defend the right.
Elizabeth Taylor. It's lovely seeing the caparisons on the horses and all the heraldry and stuff. The heraldry is more developed than it should be for this period, but anyway, it looks fantastic. The shields incidentally are clearly made of steel and they should be made of wood. Ah, a flail! So a ball on a chain flail. So that is something that occasionally appears in period art. Obviously not as common as it is in Hollywood movies. That mace is a late 15th century style mace, so that shouldn't be there, but it looks cool. Here they go. Oh, I love it. Oh. They actually look like they're trying to hit each other as well. So he's twirling that flail around. Oh, morning star type thing. So the shields clang, clang, clang. The shields are made of metal, obviously. They should be wood and leather, in historically speaking. But they really look. I love how it's rough and tumble. They look like they probably had fun and picked up a lot of bruises doing this. And they're properly whacking each other. I love how they're wheeling the horses around. They're really going for it. I love it because it kind of looks like some kind of, you know, reenactment type fighting or stuff. You see, they're properly just smashing each other. There's a degree of aiming at each other's shields. So there's a bit of aiming at the shield and not aiming at the person. But that being said, the side that they're on, it's, oh, there's one there that hit the head. It's fantastic. It's so much fun. It looks like proper. I love the way we can see what's going on. There's no crazy editing. There's no sort of handheld camera. You can see their faces because of the period of coif and armor that they're wearing. So we don't have to worry about being able to recognize who's who, although you can't see their faces really clearly. They've trusted to the heraldry and the colouring, so we know who is who. And they have got head protection, unlike so many modern movies where they're bareheaded, which is stupid. Oh, and he deliberately fell off the horse there. The saddles don't quite look right. They're not as high as period saddles. Easier to fall out of this type of saddle. So the shield is absolutely dented to heck because it's made of steel. Using the horse to ride over the person, fantastic. So if you're still on your horse and the opponent's on foot, absolutely, you try and use the horse against them. In reality, the horse would be wheeling, kicking, biting. And, you know, being ridden over by a horse is no no small thing.
Ivanhoe.
Oh, Ivanhoe.
How dare you?
Come on, Ivanhoe. He's not doing so well at the moment. So his axe looks very thick. It's clearly not made of steel. It's clearly made of rubber or wood or something. So that kind of doesn't look right. But I do like the opposing weapons, though. Axe versus flail. See, I remember watching this as a kid and it was totally inspiring. This was the sort of thing that drove me to get into things like reenactment and HEMA later in life. So he's literally just got an axe now. Oh, so it's flail, horse and shield versus just axe. Ouch. And I love the fact that you can actually see they are hitting each other. Oh, nice. So, perfect. There we go. So that's the weakness of the flexible weapon. Smack! Oh, I love it. So you know what? 1952, no CGI, no great special effects. And the stunt work was really just two guys, for a lot of the time, I think it was the actual actors, but certainly some of the time they would have been using stunt doubles, just bashing nine bells out of each other with an axe and a flail, probably the head rubber heads or something like that. But they were really going for it, and it was really fun to watch, and amazing that it's a fight on horseback where we could see the amazing mastery of the horses, the wheeling, the turning, the jockeying around. And what we know from period manuscripts, both treatises and non-treatises, is that very often when you're fighting on horseback, the superior horseman is who wins the fight, the person who can maneuver to the right place. It doesn't matter how hard and how often you swing your weapon, the fact is your horse has to be in the right place at the right time for you to be able to get onto the offside of the opponent, hit them in their non-shield side, maybe even hit the horse as well, though we don't see that here. So really seeing the activity of the horses, absolutely fantastic in this. And most of all, we could see what was going on. It was totally clear. They still had head protection, but we could tell who was who. We could precisely tell what was going on, even though it was a rough and tumble fight and there was no, you know, wacky editing. And it was just really fun to watch. And I wish that more modern Hollywood medieval combats were like that. 1952, you've got a lot to teach us. Thanks for watching. Give us a like and a subscribe if you haven't done already. I'm Matt Easton of Schola Gladiatoria, and I will continue to be, and hopefully I'll see you back here again soon. Cheers, folks. Thanks for watching. We've got extra videos on Patreon. Please give our Facebook a like and subscribe if you haven't already. Cheers, folks.